I'm here with Brian Brooks. He had the opportunity to spend a lot of time in camp with Shane Mosley. He had the chance to spar Floyd Mayweather, Manny Pacquiao, John Molina Jr. What do you think? Let me ask you this right off the bat. Yeah. Mike Tyson. What does he mean in boxing, to the boxing world?
Wow, Mike means everything. You know, you can learn a lot from Mike. I've ran across Mike one time out of my past, up in Big Bear.
You were training, he was training?
Yeah, I was training with Shane Mosley, and Mike just came up and shot some words out of encouragement. And
what he said, do you remember?
They were bowling. We were all bowling, me, him, Jack, and Shane, and that was just very overwhelming to see Mike, you know what I'm saying?
Did they let him win because they didn't want him to get mad? Or?
No.
Who won, Shane?
I don't think Mike was bowling. We were bowling.
Okay.
Me, Jack, Shane. Mike just came through the bowling alley, and, you know, they were shooting the shit. So, good guy. Very smart. A lot of people are very sarcastic about Mike and
cool
what he's been through, you know. But Mike is a very, 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 very smart guy. Very smart guy.
Who won the bowling game?
The bowling game? I think Jack probably won the game.
Jack?
Yeah.
He just dominated, huh?
Yeah, I think Jack.
Okay.
I'm gonna give it to Jack.
Okay, what did Tyson tell Shane? Was it before a fight? Obviously. Do you remember which fight?
Man, it was so many years ago, bro. It's been maybe 5-6 years ago. I really can't remember exactly what we're talking. I know it was a lot to do with life. You know what I'm saying? It was a life conversation.
My philosophy, like stick
you know
with
saying?
It.
Right.
Good or bad, whatever
yeah,
happened.
Yeah, good or bad. I pretty much heard Mike say he really didn't know what he wanted to do and when he started boxing. You know what I'm saying? He was good, but he really didn't know what he really wanted to do. And he was like, well, shit, you want to have to do something. So, you know, he said he went out there and started knocking motherfuckers out. And there it was.
For a lot of people around the world, when you mention boxing, there are two or three names that come to their mind right away. Muhammad Ali and Mike Tyson. I don't care where I am in the world.
Right.
You mention those two names and everybody's going to tell you how much they love them, appreciate their fight.
Right.
Why is that? What is it about Ali and Tyson that makes them?
Well, they were the people's champ, you know. They sold themselves to the public, you know what I'm saying? So public eye, they embrace them, they love them. And Muhammad Ali was just so special, you know what I'm saying? So special in and outside the ring, you know. So people just love the way he carries him, the way he talks, the way he handles things.
But you see, Tyson's not the greatest talker.
Right.
But he's good. And he's only 5'10", 5'11".
Right.
And he destroyed everyone.
Right. Well, Mike, when you got that beast in you, man, it just got to come out. It just got to come out. And like I said, you know, we all have made mistakes, you know, in the past. And right now, he's just patching things up, man.
Okay, my last question. Ali in his prime, Tyson in his prime. Who does Brian Brooks pick to win that fight?
Man, Muhammad Ali gonna put them things on Mike.
Nah, I think Mike got it. Mike, the power. He was just coming in sweet and...
Nope.
Ali had his jaw broken. You don't think Tyson would have broken his jaw? I mean, I don't know.
No, man.
Tyson would... All right, why would Ali beat him? Because he would box him?
Yeah, he would box him. But box him. Mike has always had a problem with big guys. Taller guys, especially with box.
So you're saying a good boxer could defuse any brawler?
Depends on how good the chin is. You know what I'm saying? We gotta have that.
You gotta have a chin in this game.
That chin detector. The chin is everything, man. The chin is everything.
So there you have it, Brian Brooks. Any message to fans if they're watching?
Hey, you guys be cool out there, all right? Put God first in everything you do.
And all the keyboard warriors that love to hate, any message to them?
Man.
Keep watching. There you have it, Brian Brooks, right here at Goose and Jim, VSreport.com, and Melissa Quack reporting.